All right, now it's live coming to you from Southern California. Happy Thursday, April 6, 2017, 9:43 a.m. in the morning, California time. I want to talk about the chemical attack in Syria. People are blaming Assad. If it's not the Russians, you know, hey, blame the Russians for everything. Or blame the Syrian government for everything. I think it's bullcrap. Can I just say that? Yeah. I have articles here I want to read that it looks like a false flag event. Here's from wearechange.org. Ron Paul, chemical attack in Syria may have been a false flag attack by deep state to undermine the peace. Well, I just did a video a couple days ago. If you go to my YouTube channel, darylawson.com, what day was that? Actually, it was April 4th. New World Order panics, wants World War III now. Wow. 20 minutes I talked about how the New World Order is freaking out that there's too much peace. There's too much undoing of Obama's agenda. Trump is coming in to reverse the curse. Trump has come in to undo Obama's agenda. Love it, and they're panicking. People are pulling out of the EU. They're panicking. Not Brexit. I'm talking about the New World Order is panicking that people are finding out that the New World Order is scheming. These secret societies that are run by the Vatican. The Vatican-run New World Order. People are finding out about that and going, man, we don't want that. We don't want the mark of the beast. We don't want to be microchipped in our right hand and our forehead. We want our own rights. We don't want to be part of the EU. And what's really going on in Syria? And why would the New World Order attack the Syrians and blame it on Assad? Ooh, think about that. I want to read this article right here. We are changed. I have several articles I want to read. Ron Paul says chemical attack in Syria may have been a false flag attack by deep state to undermine peace. I agree 100%. Wow. I mean, how come Ron Paul never became president? This guy is great. Now, my hope is that now their articles are coming out about Donald Trump talking about Obama being behind some of the chemical attack reasoning here. And I agree. Obama set this up. The Pope set this up. Clinton set this up. No, seriously. I mean, here's an article right here, globalresearch.ca. Hillary Clinton approved delivering Libya's sarin gas to Syrian rebels. I'll get to that in a moment here, but let's finish this one with We Are Change. Daryl, do you believe that Obama is behind the evil on the planet? Well, he is the Antichrist. He's scheming behind the scenes to come back into power. I've been doing video and video after that. He is the Antichrist, for heaven's sake, you know. And Pope Francis, he is the false prophet. These two are prophesied in the book of Revelation chapter 13 and other chapters in the Bible of the corrupt ones that will appear in the last days and screw the planet. I mean, hello. All right. During Wednesday's Liberty Report, Ron Paul asserted that he believes that there's a zero chance that the chemical attack in Syria was conducted by Bashar al-Assad. Quote, just days after the U.S. administration changed course on Syrian President Assad, which is great. Trump said that we are going to let the Syrian people, you know, decide what they're going to do with President Assad. We're not going to intervene. Oh, that's so good. It's nice to hear that for a change. Just days after the U.S. administration changed course on the Syrian President Assad, saying he could stay. Alleged chemical attack, a chemical weapon attack that killed dozens of civilians has been blamed on the Syrian government. Why would Assad do that? It's bull. The description for the stream read, did Assad sign his own death warrant with such an attack, or does some other entity benefit? Hello. The former Texas congressman explained that the timing of the incident was strange. Of course it is. As things were going reasonably well in Syria, given the conditions, he noted that Trump had allowed the Syrians to decide who should be running their country and that peace talks were in the works and terror groups were on the run. So why stage a sarin gas attack, right? Well, it wasn't Assad, right? It looks like, Paul said, Ron Paul, it looks like maybe somebody didn't like that, so there had to be an episode false flag event, right? And the blame now is we can't let that happen because it looks like it might benefit Assad, Paul asserted. Right, meaning that Assad is being given the benefit of the doubt. Assad's being allowed to continue. The U.S. is not going to get involved. Well, hey, whoa, the Vatican can't have that now. No, 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 we got to get involved in there. We got to We gotta blow up the sun. Listen, Obama wanted to destroy Assad a long time ago. The only reason Obama didn't get to destroy Assad in Syria was because Russia said no, no, no. And it wasn't just Russia that said no, but Russia and China told Obama no. And Obama was embarrassed. And now that President Trump is in power and has come out and said, hey, we're going to leave Assad alone. Things are working out good right there. Let the people of Syria decide what's going on. Perfect. Amazing. Oh, so the Vatican New World Order, they can't stand that. No, no, no. We need wars and rumors of wars. You know, don't forget what the Bible says over and over. Matthew 24, verse 6, Mark chapter 13, verse 7. And you shall hear of wars and rumors of wars. That's how the New World Order operates. Not just in the last days before the return of Jesus, but has for 6,000 years. This is how the fallen angels operate. They operate through taking away your rights, depopulating the earth, chemical attacks, all right, and blaming it on somebody else. Oh, it wasn't us. I didn't know. I didn't do it. You shall hear of wars and rumors of war. See that you be not troubled. Don't listen to the New World Order propaganda. Understand who's really behind it. Listen, if the CIA, the Vatican, the Jesuits, the New World Order, Obama, and these countries, a lot of the countries, most of the countries run by the Vatican behind the scenes, if they're spraying chemtrails, chemicals, by the airplanes on everybody, week after week, month after month, year after year, you don't think they're going to spray people with sarin gas or chemical gas attack in Syria? Of course they are. They're already doing it around the world. They're already injecting people all over the planet with tainted vaccinations, causing autism everywhere. Wow, be not troubled. Why? Because you know what's really going on. People panic when they think that, oh no, wow, what's going on? When they get caught up in the propaganda. For all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. Mark chapter 13, verse 7. And when you shall hear, this is Jesus speaking. When you shall hear of wars and rumors of wars, don't be troubled. See, the more information we get, the more wisdom we get, we can be at peace. Realizing these guys are twits, these guys are evil. That's what they're doing. We can circumvent it. We can hinder them. We can expose them. Be not troubled, for such things must need be, but the end is not yet. I'm telling you, that's the time we're living in right now. All right. Let me just keep on reading this article. Very fascinating. I want to go quickly because I have several articles I want to get into and touch certain subjects on this. The former Texas congressman explained that the timing of the incident, the chemical attack in Syria, was strange. Oh, you think? As things were going reasonably well in Syria, given the conditions. It looks like maybe somebody didn't like that. Ooh, that's very good. Paul then referenced the 2013 incident and the red line, quote. He noted that neoconservatives have been yelling and screaming, including a portion of the administration, that Assad used poison gas on the Syrian people. Listen, who's spraying chemtrails on the planet? It's not Assad. So why would Assad spray chemicals on his own people? You know who sprays chemicals on their own people? The CIA. The Obama administration, the Vatican, the Jesuit-run countries. Oh, yeah, the New World Order countries. I'm serious. The EU, NATO. Shall I go on? Okay, just saying. All right, look at the pattern. Ron Paul Institute of Peace and Prosperity Executive Director Daniel McAdams chimed in on this point, stating that it was never proven that the attack was conducted by Assad, Syrian president, and that the UN's Carla Del Ponte had stated the vicious assault was likely conducted by the rebels. Love it. It makes no sense, even if you were totally separate from this and take no sides on this and you were just an analyst. It doesn't make sense for Assad under these conditions to all of a sudden use poison gases, right? Right. I think it's zero chance that he would have done this deliberately, Paul said. Paul is right. You know, Paul should be. You know, I love Rand Paul and I love Ron Paul. I mean, this is, chip off the old block. You know, speaking about advisors in the White House, you know who should be the top advisors? You know, people are talking about Bannon. They're talking about Ivanka Trump, Jared Kushner. You know who should be the top advisors for Trump? It should be Ron Paul. Ron Paul should have a whole office in the White House. Ron Paul and Rand Paul should be Donald Trump's top advisors. Yeah, because they know what's going on. Paul asserted that his viewers need to decide what they stand for, urging them to consider the benefits of negotiation and diplomacy. Yeah, don't attack Assad. That's ridiculous. And I hope and I'm praying that Trump sees this. Because when Trump was doing a speech yesterday at the White House, It looked initially that he was just looking at Assad as the culprit behind the Gaza attacks. And if that's the case, that's wrong. That is propaganda. Trump's got a good heart. Trump is unplugged from the matrix. Trump is anti-New World Order. But our prayers have to go to Trump that he understands what's going on behind the scenes of all the events. There's a lot of events going on. But to listen to the mainstream media or the New World Order media is bizarre. It's crazy. No. So we got to pray that Trump finds out what's going on behind the scenes in this attack and all the things that have gone on past, present, and for the future. All right. So don't stop praying. What else did he say here? Paul asserted that his viewers need to decide. If we give up on that, then we're going to have the neoconservatives epitomized by Bill Kristol, Cheney, McCain, Lindsey Graham. They're the ones who will be running it. I mean, in many ways, this is a quote. They have a lot of influence. They're closer to the insiders. They are closer to the deep state. Ooh, that's the New World Order. Paul warned. This may well be an example of what they can do to reverse any attempt to come up with a peaceful solution. Yeah, people don't want peace. They want wars and rumors of wars. Exactly. Paul is right. Paul stated that this is why the message of non-interventionism. Don't stick your nose in everybody's business. You know, hey, let South Korea, you know, figure out and work with North Korea. All right, yeah. And then get, you know, why not let Russia and China in on it? And Japan, let them deal with North Korea. We don't, you know, the U.S. doesn't have to be into North Korea or blow up North Korea. I mean, it's ridiculous. Well, what about Kim Jong-un? What about Kim Jong-un? I mean, he's a Vatican puppet. You got to find out who's running Kim Jong-un. The same people that are running Kim Jong-un, which is the Vatican, are running Cuba. And are running ISIS. So we gotta keep that in mind. Okay. Anyways, very interesting article. We Are Change org. Powerful. Here's another one. We Are Change has a follow-up on that. False flag in Syria. False flag is when a government does terrorism and blames it on someone else. Right, yeah. And do you think this was a false flag in Syria? Of course. And it wasn't Assad. It was the CIA. It was the Jesuits. It was the Vatican. And their intelligence agencies around the world, including the CIA. Okay. False flag in Syria. Journalists raise alarms on gas attack. Here's another one. Two prominent journalists with experience on Syria believe the recent gas attack was a false flag designed to make the Trump administration go to war with Assad. Hello! That's exactly what I said. What day was that? April 4th, 2 days ago. New World Order panics, wants World War III now. Oh, here we go. Designed to make the Trump administration to go to war. Wars and rumors of war. Wars and rumors of war. With Assad, that would be a big mistake. Why? Because Russia knows it's bull. China knows it's bull. Other countries know that what's going on behind the scenes. It's just that the Western media and the New World Order media is pushing a different scenario. Okay. Anyways, they're talking about two reporters here. One, Sarah Abdallah, noticed something strange that a Syrian reporter for Gulf-based Orient TV tweeted about an attack 24 hours before it took place. Sounds like 9/11 inside job to me. All right. And she, on Twitter, she says, wow. This anti-Assad reporter tweeted about the sarin attack, hashtag Syria, 24 hours before it happened. Still think nothing fishy is going on? Wow. And then there's another, the other girl, the other reporter on Twitter, partisan girl. Same thing. Talking about the false flag indications all written all over this, yeah. She said here on Twitter, the narrative has shifted from nerve agent sarin to chlorine gas. Media quick to believe anything about evidence. Wow. In another case of coincidence, partisan girl explains that the White Helmets, received sarin protective respirator suits 1 month before the attack. Wow. Despite the Syrian government no longer owning sarin gas, according to OPCW. Oh, nothing to see there. Oh, yes, there is. And even John Kerry himself pointed it out. What was this? 2014, it says, John Kerry on Twitter, back in 2014, says, today the last 8% of declared chemical weapons were removed from Syria. Great work done by all involved. What? How could Assad do it with no gas? Yeah, okay. Boy, oh boy, they're trying to cover their tracks right now. Here's one from InfoWars. Soros, George Soros, the goofball, what do you call him? Demon-possessed troll from under a bridge. Report, Soros-linked group behind chemical attack in Syria. Oh, surprise, surprise. And by the way, who runs George Soros? The Vatican does. Chemical attack is all the hallmarks of a false flag. Oh, more false flag information. The White Helmets, an Al-Qaeda-affiliated group funded by George Soros, and the British government, surprise, surprise. Well, hey, the British government has been for years working for the Vatican, right? Now, Theresa May seems to be maybe a new cloth coming into power now, and she's, you know, Brexit, anti-EU. It's good. But nevertheless, you have tentacles running through the British government. Oh, for years, for a long time. Okay. The White Helmets and Al-Qaeda, same thing as ISIS, Muslim Brotherhood, affiliated group funded by George Soros and the British government, have reportedly staged another chemical weapon attack on civilians in the Syrian city of Khan Shakhun to lay blame on the Syrian government. So who did it? Is that Georgie boy, Georgie Porgy? And the British government? Ooh. A day prior to the attack, Gulf-based Orient TV announced, tomorrow we are launching a media campaign to cover the airstrikes on Hama countryside, including the use of chemical warfare against civilians. Again, more proof that this was a false flag attack, pre-planned, not by Assad, but by the New World Order. All right. Several children appeared in the video suffocating from unknown chemical substance, while others appeared to have unexplained head injuries. Wow, it's known 250 people were kidnapped by Al-Qaeda or ISIS last week from the nearby city of Hama, H-A-M-A. This sounds like a total fabrication, which is the same number as the current body count and wounded civilians. Another coincidence, a Pakistani-British doctor who at the time of the attack was taking interview requests instead of helping the injured who were flooding in. So yeah, he's doing interviews instead of helping the people. And additionally, he received gas masks from a British organization 3 days prior to the attack. Ooh! The doctor, Shahjul Islam, is being used as a source by US and UK media, despite facing terror charges for kidnapping and torturing two British journalists. Oh, that guy's reliable. Not. And being struck off the medical register. Okay, who's this CIA doctor? Wow, wow, wow. Very interesting article. Okay, next article. I'm just going to lump them all together. Here's another one from Global Research CA. Syria chemical weapons, red flags, and false flags. Yes, yes, and yes. There are too many red flags, it says, about the chemical weapons attack in northern Syria to believe the official version of events that immediately assigned guilt, I mean, to the Assad government. It's Russia, 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 Assad, Assad, Assyria, Assyria. Who's ever going to blame the Vatican? Who's ever going to blame the New World Order, these secret societies, the Jesuits? Who's going to blame them for a change? Mystery Babylon, the Bible calls them. Mystery, secret. They work behind the scenes. You don't think the Vatican's controlling the British intelligence? Of course they are. The Vatican controls British intelligence, Israeli intelligence, American intelligence. Oh, yeah. Trump's got his hands full with the CIA and FBI. A lot of them are working for foreign governments. Oh, yes, they are. And they're going to try to hold the information as much as they can from their commander-in-chief, so he doesn't find out what they're really doing. Just saying. Each of the red flags, false flags, and red flags, on the other hand, strongly suggest that the incident was yet another false flag operation perpetrated by the terrorists with a view to destroying the peace process and prolonging the war. Oh, war is money. War is control. Does the Assad government benefit from the chemical weapons attack on innocent people when he is winning the war and peace is on the horizon? No, the Assad government is no way benefits. Who benefits? Oh, I tell you, the New World Order. Do imperial terrorist proxies benefit, meaning run by the Jesuits and Vatican, benefit from demonizing Assad and hastily accusing him of killing his own people? Yes, they do. Was there foreknowledge of the event? Apparently so. Which we just explained, right? Wow, wow, wow. NATO warmongers do not want peace. You know, Trump was right when he said he needs to close down NATO. NATO is just an arm of the Vatican. Arm, a tentacle of the beast. It says, these red flags, false flags, demand an independent investigation. At the very least, the totality of these red flags demand an independent investigation, which would likely take weeks rather than hours. In matters of war and peace, thorough investigation should be a matter of importance. Yeah, well, like that's going to happen. You know, people like you and I, it's our responsibility to get the information out on social media. You know, Donald Trump won the U.S. presidency because of social media. You know that, right? Yeah, so it's very important to pass this information on to everybody and realize, hey, and to Trump. Trump, I believe he's been getting, hopefully he gets this information. I mean, how could he not? So that they can be exposed and the plans for war and World War III be averted. Yeah, oh yeah. Matters of war and peace, thorough investigation should be a matter of importance and priority, but accusations already infesting mainstream media. So the more likely outcome is that the incident will be used to falsely blame the Assad government, which has already been happening yesterday, with a view to prolong the war and destroy Syria and her people. Again, NATO warmongers do not want peace. Yeah, NATO on NATO. Now let's read this article quickly here on Hillary Clinton. This one was back from April 28, 2016, last year. Hillary Clinton approved delivering Libya's sarin gas to Syrian rebels. So who's in charge of bringing the weapons of mass destruction around the planet to kill people? I mean, you got the Clintons. You got the John Kerrys. You got the Obamas. You got the Jesuits. You got the Vatican. You got NATO. You got the UN. Oh, yeah. The great investigative journalist Seymour Hersh, in two previous articles in the London Review of Books, has reported that the Obama administration falsely blamed the government of Syria, Bashar al-Assad, for the sarin gas attack that Obama was trying to use an excuse to invade Syria. This is an article back from 2016. It's just trying to repeat itself today. Hersh pointed out to a report from British intelligence saying that the sarin that was used didn't come from the Assad stockpiles. Hearst also said that secret agreement in 2012 was reached between Obama administration and the leaders of Turkey, Saudi Arabia, and Qatar to set up a sarin gas attack and blame it on Assad. Oh! I mean, that's why I say, you know, President Trump needs people who do these articles and Ron Paul and Rand Paul as their top advisors to know what's really going on behind the scenes, yeah. Forget about CBS. Forget about ABC, a bunch of crap news. CNN, Communist News Network. Foxy News. You know. Now, Foxy News is a little better. I call Fox News Foxy News. But they're not that much better. Yeah, you have a few people on there, but you do have twisting and turning of the news also. They bring a little bit of truth and they mix it with a whole bunch of crap as well on Fox News as well. They're a little bit better than the rest, but not much. Anyways. I mean, take Tucker Carlson. He's great. Take a Hannity. But the other ones kind of mix things around a lot of times. Not all of them. But I'd say half and half at least. Okay, anyways. There was a secret agreement to blame Assad back in 2012, right? Ooh, let's get Turkey, Saudi Arabia, Qatar involved. And so these plans are not just new. It's not just propaganda from... thought up this year. This has been going on for years, back to 2012 or before. But by the terms of the agreement, funding came from Turkey as well as Saudi Arabia and Qatar. The CIA, oh, surprise, surprise, with the support of MI6, oh, was responsible for getting arms from Gaddafi's arsenals into Syria. Now, it was pre-planned. You got to get rid of Muammar Gaddafi, Libyan president, in order to rape the country, steal their stuff, and cause more wars. Exactly. That's what happened in Iraq. And so that's what happened in Libya. And they're trying to do the same thing in Syria. They need chaos. Freaks. I have a great article. I'm not going to read the whole article. And as if it weren't enough, even the definitive analysis of the evidence that was performed by two leading U.S. analysts, the Lloyd Postal Report, concluded that the U.S. government's interpretation of the technical intelligence it gathered prior to and after the attack cannot possibly be correct. Obama has clearly been lying. Oh, surprise, surprise, right? Yeah. But in this article back from 2016, it says for the first time Hillary Clinton has been implicated. Hirsch has implicated Hillary Clinton directly in this rat line. Ooh. Why did they actually kick Hillary Clinton out of the Secretary of State position? It was probably because they had too much dirt on her. And she got people found out what she was doing. So they brought in another skull and bones radical crazy. And John Kerry, yeah. Oof. To be blamed on Assad in order to justify the U.S. invading Syria. It's a miracle that the U.S. hasn't really totally taken over and crushed Syria. Putin said no, China said no, and they always get caught in their false flag events. Yeah, I love it. They were to collect weapons from Libyan stockpiles. This is Hillary Clinton's doing. And send them through Turkey into Syria. For a setup, sarin gas attack. This came out last year, a year ago. To be blamed on Assad in order to justify the U.S. invading Syria, as the U.S. had invaded Libya to eliminate Gaddafi. That ambassador, speaking about Libya, who was killed, he was known as a guy, from what I understand, as somebody who would not get in the way of the CIA. As I wrote, on the day of the mission, he was meeting with the CIA base chief and the shipping company. He was certainly involved, aware and witting of everything that was going on. I mean, all these guys are connected. There's a lot of speculation what happened in the U.S. ambassador being killed in Benghazi, Libya. Some people say he was in on it. Some people say that he was exposing gun running, drug running, chemical running. Nevertheless, they killed him. Oh, the Obama administration, Hillary Clinton, killed the U.S. ambassador in Libya. Benghazi, Libya. Yeah. So, I mean, if they'll kill a U.S. ambassador, they'll kill anybody else. If they killed JFK, if the Vatican secret societies killed the JFK, which they did, they'll kill a U.S. president, they'll kill a U.S. ambassador, they'll kill anybody, yeah. Anyway, more information on there, how Hillary's connected to this as well. Wow, and Obama. Listen, it's not just Susan Rice. Oh, she's the spying person. No, national security, no. When you talk about Susan Rice, you have to talk about Obama. Obama's behind it. If you talk about Clinton, you have to talk about Obama. He's hiding. Another one here by prepforthat.com, great name. False flag chemical weapons attack in Syria to push for World War III. The U.S. government and the Western power structure as a whole is completely out of control. Surprise, surprise. Though there's no denying the corruption and criminality that is rampant in other countries. The most dangerous, desperate behavior being displayed by a global power center is that of the U.S. NATO Trump administration. Well, I wouldn't say Trump administration. They're lumping him in here, but it's not him. And I hope Trump understands what's going on in this gas attack. Yeah. The U.S. NATO military-industrial complex wants total global power and will stop at nothing in the attempt to achieve it. The latest desired excuse to ramp up U.S. NATO military aggression in the Middle East has now been conveniently provided. But what really happened? Why? Do Americans even remember the earlier false flag chemical weapons attack that was staged in Syria? just as the UN weapons inspectors arrived in Syria. Oh, surprise, surprise. Does any rational person believe the Syrians would invite the UN inspectors to the country after giving up all their chemical weapons willingly and then launch a chemical weapons attack? We were talking about that earlier. Okay. What does Google show when you search Trump Syria chemical weapons attack? The Google search results show only the criminally corrupt mainstream media official military industrial complex narrative. That is what the criminal corporate media are paid to do. Yeah, yeah. Like, for instance, headlines. Trump says heinous chemical weapons strike in Syria cannot be tolerated. Blaming Assad, Trump says Syria attack cannot be tolerated. Trump blames Assad and Obama for chemical attack. Well, Obama's right. Assad is wrong. You know, people grow in their understanding, right? Just because you're U.S. president doesn't mean you have the full intelligence, especially when people are lying to you to try to manipulate a U.S. president. So Trump has to be very careful on who he gets his information from. The U.S. mainstream media is a criminal collaborator and contributor to the totally tyrannical and completely out of control military-industrial complex. Well, what do you expect? Run by the CIA, run by the Vatican. What else is happening in Syria and all over the world that mainstream media has never said a word about? Well, they're actually in this article bringing about chemtrails as well. Ooh, that's right. So I'm glad that this article is linking the chemtrails to the craziness of their behavior, that the New World Order sprays people with chemicals all the time, poisons people, puts fluoride in your water, says it's good for you. Tries to get mandatory vaccinations that are poison, tainted vaccinations. So, of course, who's behind it? The same people behind the vaccinations, behind the chemtrails, or behind the gas attack in Syria. And it's not Assad. Oh! Great article linking that. Oh, look, and don't forget, I don't have time to get into this article, but here's one from yournewswire.com. Putin says 95% of world terrorist attacks are orchestrated by the CIA. He's right. Wonder why they always blame Russia, because Putin is a danger to the New World Order. Putin hits the nail on the head. Putin says 95% of world terrorist attacks are orchestrated by the CIA. Oh, the CIA works for the Jesuits, the Vatican. You can read that at yournewswire.com, I mean, yeah. Love it, love it, love it. Don't forget, yeah, this is a great article. And you wonder why the intelligence committee is trying, you know, this waste of time trying to blame Russia for interfering in U.S. elections. If he did, give him a medal, because he deserves a medal for getting out Hillary Clinton. But Trump, Putin's not the problem. Putin has the answers. All right. I'd love to read all these articles, but I can't, right? Let me just read a paragraph or two. Putin claimed that the CIA is a rogue element. He's right. Of the deep state. An expression of the will of the world oligarchy and the vision of the New World Order. He's right. I wish the people would come out and say, I mean, that's powerful. But people need to connect the Vatican to this. The Vatican is the richest organization on the planet that runs most intelligence agencies and most governments on the planet. Book of Revelation is clear about that. Yeah. Suffice to say, the CIA exists as part of America, but it's certainly not American. Ooh. The CIA does not work on behalf of the American people or act in their interests. Bingo! Give them the prize. Now they're linking this. Well, they're talking about the St. Petersburg bombing. Asked if he thought the St. Petersburg bomb was the beginning of a CIA plot to oust him from power, as has been suggested in the media. Putin said it will take more than a bag of tricks in a subway to make me blink. Ha ha ho! Love it. Anyways, I'm gonna leave it there at that. But I just wanted to, you know, there's article after article coming out about this information, and I wanted to make it clear that, listen, Assad is not the person behind the Gaza attack in Syria. It is the Vatican. It is the secret societies. It is the New World Order. It is the Jesuits. It is the CIA. It is the British intelligence. You throw in the, listen, the Israeli intelligence, you got to throw them in there as well. Because this, the Turkey's involved. Oh, yeah. You got Qatar, you got Saudi Arabia. Now, when you deal, Turkey is a whole different ball of wax. I think the Turkish president is a little bit wary now of the CIA because I think they tried to blame and cause a World War III nuclear war, blaming Turkey for it several months ago. And I think Turkey is pulling closer to Russia. We'll see. Because I think the president of Turkey realized that he was being double-crossed by the CIA. If you find out about that, you read about and study the coup, the attempted coup against Turkish president. And the possible, I think the New World Order wanted to start a World War III around the time of the election, of the U.S. election, yeah. But the Lord held it back and the world is still here. Oh, love it. Listen, we need to expose this information, get this information out, and pray that Donald Trump gets the right information. That he gets the Ron Paul information. He gets the We Are Change information. He gets the Rand Paul information. He gets the InfoWars. All right? The global research. We need to pray that this information has free course. That the mind-blinding spirits are bound. And that people understand what's really going on. Especially for Donald Trump right now. But all of us included. All right, let's pray. Father, we ask that you would cause this information to get into the right hands. And that you would protect the Syrian people. Protect Assad, because he's really working for his people. Protect the countries from the New World Order agenda. Thank you, Father. Let your kingdom come. Let your will be done on earth as in heaven every day. In Jesus' name, by the Holy Spirit, amen and amen. All right, Daryl Lawson Live signing off. Go to my website, daryllawson.com. Check out all my videos. I'm looking at my videos right here. 1,494 videos that I've done on YouTube. Plus several hundred on Facebook Live as well. You can see a lot more at daryllawson.com. All right, I'm doing a live program here in a few minutes. 10 a.m. and 2 p.m. Monday through Friday and even Sunday mornings, 10 a.m. daryllawson.com. All right, I love you guys. Keep up the good work. I'll see you later. God bless you. Bye. Sunday mornings, 10 a.m. daryllawson.com. All right, I love you guys. Keep up the good work. I'll see you later. God bless you.